second there for it, and it came back, and you were at a party at a lacrosse house or something, whatever it was. And people always ask me, you know, when I say I have my phone on my bed, they say, why do you have your phone on when you have to get up so early? I said, when you have kids, you have your phone on, because you just never know. And I got that call at 3:15. I looked, it was 3:15 in the morning, and I saw his ID, and I went, oh, God, there's no way this could be good. But luckily, at least I saw his name on it, so I knew it was his phone. And he very calmly said, Dad, you know, I'm at a party, and the cops are here, and I'm getting arrested. I said, well, I mean, were you drinking? He said, yeah, basically he's like, the shame of it is I'm not even drunk. But, you know, he was underage, so any alcohol he drank, he was going to get popped for. So there were like 40 people arrested that night. And who were the two headliners? The two football players, Mike and a guy named Will Yateman. So here's me at 4 in the morning. It's starting to go on the wire everywhere. So I had to talk about it, obviously on air. So that was an interesting moment where you talk about the fun things, like the day he signed with Notre Dame. He came on air with me and my son Jake when he signed with Notre Dame, and my daughter when she swam in Notre Dame. But here's a sign I had to talk about him being arrested. And I did. And I was very honest and open. People thought, oh, my God, are you going to really punish him? I said, hey, two things. Don't be drinking and driving, and don't be alone if you're doing, you know, if you're with a group. And he was. And the first thing I said to him was, why the hell didn't you run? And why didn't you run?
There were dogs outside. Big dogs.
I said,
you're
not running.
I wanted to come out of that neck hole. Thankfully, yeah. I was able to. Now, everyone dreams, too, of like being on SportsCenter Top 10 or seeing their name on the bottom line. Getting bailed out in the morning and then going back to your dorm room and seeing your name along the bottom line in that red ticker tape, not exactly the way I envisioned it going.
You want to see a great thing. Take off your hat for a moment. Mike's 27, and let's just be honest, he's balding.
Follow the shot.
Okay?
If you balding's our word.
If you Google Mike Golic mugshot, you'll see a different look of him. He looks like a mass murderer. With his long hair and thick beard, it's hilarious.
It was an interesting look at the time. I think it was popular in 2008. Yeah.
I think most dads say, go Google my son and look for his mugshot. That's a very common thing.
It's a proud moment, huh?